the most famous personalities of Indian cinema is with us today, and he needs no introduction. Please welcome Anupam Kher with a big round of applause. Now, I take immense pleasure in welcoming you all to the book launch of Tears of Jhelum, written by Anita Krishan. Mrs. Krishan is an author and educationist and has worked relentlessly with the young generation to bring about environmental awareness. She discovered her vocation as a writer much later in life, but since then, she has never looked back and is penning down her stories and thoughts fervently ever since. May I now invite Mrs. Anita Krishan to deliver her welcome address.
First of all, I wholeheartedly welcome our chief guest, Anupam Kher. Thank you, Anupam, for squeezing time out from your busy schedule to be here tonight. Anupam and I have a very long association. We were together in college 40 years ago, from 1971 to 74 in our undergraduate years. Ladies and gentlemen, you won't believe that time we didn't even say hello to each other. There was a reason. You know, it was a very different era, and we had a very strict principal, Mr. Handa. And he used to make sure that the girls and boys did not interact despite the fact we studied in a co-ed college. So I remember one episode. We girls were standing in a college compound, and one of my friends points at a boy and tells me, you know, that fellow, his name is Anupam Kher. I look at this thin, lanky, very fair boy with a thick, curly crop of red hair. And I said, so? She says, he's in my class. Do you want an introduction? We say, well, go and say hello. I said, are you mad? Anupam ko hello bolne jayenge aur principal ki office mein pahunch jayenge. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's the tragic story. I could say hello to Anupam Kher while I'm in my college. You have to bear with me because Anupam Kher is the chief guest. I want to take him down a memory lane a little. Those good old college days. One incident that comes to my mind, we had been in college just barely a month it had been when there was an excitement in the college. And I believe a fellow, a Shimlight, had an encounter with ghosts right above our college. Remember, Anupam? And it turned out that it was a prank played by medical college students. They had tied some hooves on their hands and they scared a man almost to a heart attack. Another thing that happened that time was the rainfall. Remember the first rainfall, first year, it came with a thunder. It had never poured like that ever in Chennai. I think it's never poured like that ever since. It rained and rained and rained, and Shimla was cut off from the rest of the country, and we had holidays in college. So good holidays in rain, we enjoyed them. That year, in winters, started Indo-Pak War. And people, our soldiers, went to the borders to defend them. And a group of them landed in our college to give us training to, you know, shoot rifles. Two rifles, it used to be, you know, load one bullet, shoot, load one bullet. Now I wonder how our soldiers used to fight with them those days. And this time, when the soldiers came for rifle training, Mr. Handa said, no difference between boys and girls. Everybody learns how to shoot a rifle. So we all learned how to shoot a rifle. And after about a fortnight of training, we went down to a shooting range. They wanted to check how good we were. Were we fit enough to go to the border in case we were needed to fight the battle, the war with Pakistan. And it so happened all of us were there. The whole college was there. Of course, with Ms. Handa supervising whether there should be any hellos between boys and girls. And a tragic thing happened. Our college caught fire while we were there. And it got, interiors got burnt, and we were left without a college. We didn't realize the seriousness that time, because we had the classes were arranged elsewhere, but for a while we were without a building, a college building.